their questions, because it is very essential, first for your oral exam, which is coming soon, and second for your final exam, where you have to write sentences and also questions. So let us learn this, so that we can do that correctly. So first, to start up with this, I don't know, maybe somebody not coming in later, I don't know. We start quite slowly, simple, with some questions. Can you, I have here a small paper, just write one question, anyone which comes into your mind, regarding, maybe we can focus already a little bit on the schedule, so this is the last what we have done so far. I hope I must not repeat the time right now. Are you okay with the time? How to say the time from the watch? So, wie spät ist es jetzt? Just a short check.
4 nach 12.
4 nach 12. I watch so fast. 7 nach 12. Ich habe already 12 nach 12. 5 minutes fast. Okay, then I don't blame you when you are late. My watch is 5 minutes back. Jason! Okay. You are in the green area. So. Alright. One paper for you for one question. You can close the books. You don't need now books. Right? One question.
What you wear, or what you pack, or what you buy, or just
in general. When you don't know the word in German, how do you ask? No, what is that? It's only what is it, right? But let me, I just give the question to all of you. How to say in German, or how to ask in German for the term in German language of anything? Let's say dress, then you want to ask how, let's say it's a blouse or what, but how is that called in German language? How do you ask for that in German? Almost. One word you change. Two words. Was ist das auf Deutsch? Ist acceptable.
Wie.
Wie is better. And then noch another word.
Wie heißt
das auf Deutsch? Exactly. Yes. Wie heißt das auf Deutsch? So das you replace then with that piece what you mean. Wie heißt, I will know what you want to ask for. Yeah, which Kleidungsstück do you want to know in German? Yeah, so wie heißt Pants auf Deutsch? Wie heißt Pants in quotation marks auf Deutsch? That's what we use. And what is the other one? Yeah, that is correct. Okay. So, are there any complaints? You are not sure if it is correct or not? Wie alt ist das? The book. Or a person. A person cannot be das. That is very rude, yeah, by that. Hmm? Yeah, or a name, right? Wie alt ist Bea? Yeah, or wie alt ist Herr Schmidt? You have a question? This you should know. Yeah, for example. Yes, wie heißen deine Eltern? Oder when you want to do it formal? Ihre, with a capital I, right? Yes. Do you correct it, please? Go ahead, please. Okay. After you do that, you're right. Then, yeah, good. Wie? Yeah. Wie is du? What do you mean du? I don't know what is your question. Point of thoughts. But what do you want to know?
All of the time.
You want to ask something about the hose, but what?
How the hose is.
That is what you see. No. Okay. So when you just talk on the phone, say, I bought a new pants, right? I bought new pants, and you ask me, how is it looking like? So wie ist? Then you need an article there. Yeah. For example. Yeah. Oder die. Oder, yeah. This one I saw already.
Not yet.
Not yet. Ask him your question which you have right now in hands.
Okay.
Wie heißen Sie?
Ich heiße Alexander.
Okay, then what's your question? And whom do you ask? Wen fragen Sie?
Maria Rassi. Wo wohnen Sie?
Ich wohne in Tee. Jason, wie ist dein Hose?
Mein Hose ist blau.
Feine.
Meine Hose ist blau. Baby. Wie alt bist du?
Alt.
Wie alt bist du?
Ich bin 21 Jahre alt. Schon. One step to out.
What?
One step to out.
Pronounce properly, please. Oh, very important for your oral exam.
That's the way. One step you out.
Wann stehst du auf?
Wann stehst du auf?
Was stehst du auf?
Dienstag um 9 am
was kostet der Tee?
Which is what? V is how. Which is the power? Okay. Faben? Ja, wenn du es nur have colors, right? Has. Das Mädchen, which color? Colors has the how do you call it? Pencil box. Yes.
That your father has like a kid.
Sweat. So this was not so difficult, but so how?
My mention is Swas un Gel un
Rau. Yeah, okay. Except it. You want to know some more about it? Okay, you have now a question to who? Who did it not yet? Kenza. Okay.
Was Mas Dugan?
Was Mas Dugan? Ich gehe gern schwimmen. Alright. Okay. So you could do that quite well, that's fine. So now we still have this to control, to prove if it is right or wrong. So how we do that? How we go for that to check if it is right or wrong? Any idea? Ask the teacher. Teacher said, I don't know. So, who else you can ask? Dictionary? Yes, you could try. Should I give you dictionary? We have a few of them. What you find there? See if it helps you. Who needs dictionary? Stehe auf oder aufstehe. So now, how to decide? You want to vote? How? Any proofs? Where else you can look in? So that you see that better. verb, which you use in the second position and conjugate as usual. So what you do with the prefix? You have to separate. Yeah, should be some scissors here, okay? You have to cut. You have to cut them. And then you use it in which way? This or this? This. So this is here our prefix. And this is our verb. Yeah? That is this part. And this is the prefix. This is the verb. And this is the prefix. Okay, I write. I must do it here also to read. That is the way you use it. So when you put a sentence and you make a sentence using a trennbares verb, there must be the full stop here behind the prefix. That is the last piece in the sentence, the last little single word. And these prefixes are words which have an own existence, that have an own meaning. These are small prepositions. Like this, auf means on top. So when I say aufstehen, that means I stand. I stand on my own feet. I stand on the floor. I don't lay down anymore. I wake up, bangun, go from horizontal to vertical. Okay? Oder aufschreiben is to write on paper. Yeah? So that is how they change the meaning of the root word. And there are quite a number of them, and we come to know them today a bit more. So we have here some in the book here, Seite 45. You see there, anfangen. Anfangen is the meaning of anfangen. To start, yes, anrufen, anrufen is to call somebody on the phone, yeah, it's not that you are talking already on the phone, it's to dial, so you get that person on the phone. Then the next one is aufschreiben, I just mentioned it, you write down on the piece of paper. Aufstehen, we have here. Ausprobieren. Aus means out, but here it does not really make sense. Yeah, doch, when it comes to the English translation, you use also out. To try out is to ausprobieren, is to test something, to try it, is ausprobieren. Und Fernsehen? We had already earlier, right? Is to watch TV. The next one is mitkommen. Mit. Do you know the meaning of mit?
With.
So kommen, you know. So mitkommen is to come along. Yeah, to follow. I follow you. So I come mit dir. Und zuhören. Listen, yeah. Hören, you know already, that is to hear, and zuhören is carefully listening. Yes. So we know that, right? So now we try to use them also correctly. And therefore, we have exercise here in the workbook. I hope you have your workbook with you. Ihr seid 35 in this workbook part. format before we come to this page and before we get to the format. You write one of your favorite Trennbares Verbi on top. One of your favorite Trennbares Verbi. Ja, ein trennbares Verb, wenn du auch nicht trinken möchtest. Which you prefer? Ein trennbares Verb, which you prefer? Anyone? In infinity. Anyone? We have now a few. You take one of them, or anyone you can create. No one. Can you guess what is to go out? To go out party. To go out. What is that in Deutsch? Ausgehen. Yeah, so easy. Yes. Ausgehen. To go out. Yeah. So you have one on your piece of paper. You have? But it looks like two words. Let me see.
No.
It is one word. What is that?
No,
that is one trennbares Verb. Anyone from here, our list, or another one? It's not a big deal, just one word. Just write down one word. Good? Done? Maybe you uncommon, to arrive. House common? Yeah, it is. Means your salary is enough for you to, is enough to finish 1 month with it. Yeah, I just try to explain to you. I mean, it's just your salary is enough for 1 month to settle your expenses. Ich komme aus. But maybe we use the easier word. Maybe you also use
Yeah.
check out. You have to check out from. You mean from by the aeroplane or something like that?
No.
Check out is in the sense of testing.
Same meaning. I separately can different.
This Alexander cannot go on top there. It's tall enough. I must be correct, I am not so tall to do correction. Yeah. Yeah. Are the rules and regulations fulfilled?
Yes.
What are the rules and regulations, John?
Please separate it.
Okay, separate it.
Prefix is at the back.
Prefix is at the back. Must be at the back. After that, it's only full stop. Done?
Done.
This is the word. This is the prefix, right? And it's conjugated, so that is why I want you to use it. Okay, so here is the prefix, and this is the verb. Okay, this is correct. So, ich stehe, also that was, ich schreibe Informationen auf. Of course, this was correct, this been confirmed already. And this is wrong, I don't want to see this anymore in your papers, right? Ich schreibe Informationen auf. Komm her, Michelle. Richtig? Ist hier richtig? Do you understand the meaning of the sentence? Nein? Theresa, allow. Aufschreiben is on a piece of paper, right? Auf is on. So you write on a piece of paper, you write down information. Yeah, it's correct, right? Here's the verb, conjugated, and here's the prefix. Correct. Ich schreibe Hausaufgaben um 8 Uhr am Abend auf. Ist das richtig oder falsch? It's already longer, huh? Not so easy to look through. So how? You say richtig. Patrick, what do you say?
Change
am Abend und um. Ach so, ja, that is small matter, okay. This I can do for you. That is small matter. Am Abend um 8 Uhr, ich schreibe Hausaufgaben am Abend um 8 Uhr auf. Galait, no need for this sentence to use aufschreiben. Galait, Hausaufgaben machen is the correct term. It is from the words, from the vocab, not really matching, but for sake of the use of aufschreiben, okay, can be accepted, but it is not very good German, alright? So, ich mache Hausaufgaben, ja? Not ich schreibe auf, okay? So, can we maybe think of something else to make it a bit better? What do you write down? Words, what words? Any lyrics, maybe? Lyrics? Or any song?
Yes, song.
lyrics are Liedtexte. Ich schreibe Liedtexte. Liedtexte. Am Abend, am Abend. Um 8 Uhr auf. Is that correct?
Yeah.
Nein! That's why I was so disappointed in the test yesterday. I was really disappointed. Personally, Saki Kati, and I was asking myself, what did I teach you? So many mistakes have been done with the sentence structures, like in this example, very obviously to be seen. What is the mistake here? Who gets 100 dropout point? No. What is our rule in sentence structures?
Subject.
Subject, verb, completion. Of? Of? Yeah, okay, when you think of it, it's fine. And 1, 2, 3. Alright?
Yeah.
So where's your 1? 1 is the subject. The verb. Completion. What about the time, my dears? Friends? The time goes where?
Goes after verbs.
The completion is in this case here our time. And the time has to be first. And number 4 will be the completion. Is anything else that would be here our object, our leaf text. So, we have to do the whole thing. This all comes here, right? And the leaf text comes there. So, Schreiber, am Abend. Meine Schwester zu. short explanation which you didn't get maybe by our personal dialogues here. Two of them wanted to say they want to listen to the music, okay? But when you listen to music, we don't use in German so really zuhören. We say only wir hören Musik. Yeah? Or when you go to a concert, for example, then you would say ich höre im Konzert zu. Okay? But maybe we use here a person who is playing piano or whatever, or your mother is saying something which you listen carefully. Then you can use this one. And it should be a small correction here which you don't know yet. That must be here an A. Ich höre meiner Mutter zu und ich höre meiner Schwester zu. That is next level, alright? Okay, we can keep it, we can accept that. When we want to listen to music, you say, ich höre dem Konzert zu. Yeah? So this is the verb. And zu, zu. Okay. When we say mit meiner, here also say, must be an R at the back. This is, you cannot know that now, so don't worry when you don't have it. Ich sehe mit meiner Schwester fern. It's correct, right? Verb and prefix. Ich sehe Film am Morgen fern. Ich sehe Film am Morgen, that is morgen, am Morgen fern. This cannot. This really cannot. Because, as I said already, Fernsehen includes everything. You watch TV and that means you watch something in the hardware TV as well. That includes all. So when you say, ich sehe fern, ich sehe am Morgen, right? Should be an O. Ich sehe am Morgen fern, capital M or so. Ich sehe am Morgen fern, that means you are watching in the morning anything in the TV, if it is a movie or the news or whatever, you don't know. But when you want to say you're watching a movie in the TV, then you cannot use Fernsehen. Then you must say something else. Then you must say, ich sehe. Here must be something im Fernsehen. So that means here now I see a movie in the TV. Here is the TV, the hardware. That's why it is a capital letter. When I say here, ich sehe am Morgen fern. Sehe am Morgen fern, so that is a correct sentence like this. Here is the prefix and here is the verb. That means only I am watching TV in the morning. So, but when I want to say I am watching a movie in the TV, then I must use this sentence. You cannot use Fernsehen, you must say I see something in the TV. And here must be an article, right? So which one?
Ein.
Suggestion is ein. Any corrections? That means in other words it is wrong already, yeah? Why Einen, Alexander? It's the way you said it, Einen. Yeah, that sounds so... Of course, it must be Einen, but you are right. But why it must be Einen? Einen film.
Oh, yeah, the film is not watching.
Yeah, otherwise the movie watches you. Right? So, I am the subject, the movie is the object. And the movie is masculine on top of that. So, you must use I did. Okay? Remember? The cheese and mouse? So, this one also settled. So, hier no fern at the back. Yeah? That is different. So, ich lese Buch am Abend für whom? You mean for. You mean not für, you mean for, right? Vorlesen. For. For is, vorlesen is to read aloud. For is in front. Yeah, so you read aloud in front of others. Okay? So I read a book in the evening to somewhere, to somebody else. Here also is missing a article. And what else is wrong? So Jabali. Yes. It means the construction, the structure of the sentence. This one is here, right?
Yes.
So what we have here?
T-E-S.
The prefix. ambiguity. Okay? Make my big space here, this one we don't need, right? the construction, the structure of the sentence. This one is here, right?
Yes.
So what we have here? This is also possible. But the better version is 1 and 3. Right? 1 and 3 are the one which you better choose when you make your sentences. Okay, so this one gets red star. Alright? So this one has a preferred version. Following this here. Yeah? Please don't forget this, yeah? I really, really, really put it into your heart. You have to remember this when you make sentence structures. Alright? So, let us now practice now a little bit on this page 35, which is already on your table from beginning of the class. So we have now learned a lot of these prefixes. So now try the other way around. Put them together again. Do you still remember? After now how many minutes already? What belongs together? Which prefix to which verb? Separating is nicely done, right? But then afterwards? Oh, here are some pieces of paper. No, empty. Empty, right? And you don't please leave it afterwards on the floor, yeah? To pick it up again. How do they match together? Then the opposite would be uncommon to arrive. Okay.
Auf
Aufhören. Aufhören ist to stop something. You are okay? Anfangen ist to start something. The new lesson, the new chapter. The teacher starts a new chapter. Anfangen. Ausprobieren is only one possibility. Ausprobieren. She tries a new exercise. Übungs exercise. Alle, everybody, all.
Write down.
On a piece of paper. This out you can imagine like on a piece of paper. So I forgot to watch, yeah, our time is running out. So I just want to make sure that we have the correct answers. Can we just check? What are the words in when you put them back to someone by leg, the prefix and the verb, then you will have which words are in stand up? Just it's number 50. Zuhören, ja? Next one? So else you have that? Yeah.
Ausgehen,
ja.
Ankommen.
Ankommen, to arrive, yes.
Das ist nicht
mitkommen, also okay. Das ist auch more possibilities to join them together, ja.
Anrufen,
to call. Aufhören, you can also say. Aufhören.
Aufhören.
Is the opposite of anfangen. Yes. To stop. We do that also in a singing language.
Ausprobieren,
jawohl. Yes, correct. Do you have to do something else? I think the majority we got already, yeah? Okay, then just the last small paragraph there. This one here. How do you fill in the prefixes there? In the blanks, where comes what? Am Freitag steht Martina um 6:30. Die Schule fängt 8:00. Im Deutschunterricht hört sie gut. Die Lehrerin fängt eine neue Lektion. Sie probiert auch eine neue Übung. Alle schreiben. Ja, auf oder mit. You can choose there. Am Nachmittag ruft Martina ihre Freundin Betty. Sie sagt, ich gehe ins Tanzforum. Kommst du? Betty tanzt auch gern und geht.
Auf.
Mit. Oder nicht? Mit. Mit? Yeah, she goes with what is the name of the girl? Martina. She goes with Martina. Mit. Should be mit, eh? Betty tanzt auch gern und geht mit. She also likes to dance and joins her to go to this dance forum. Am Abend sehen sie bei Betty. Und müde schlafen sie ein. Ja, ein ist, also einschlafen ist a new word hier. Einschlafen means to fall asleep. Einschlafen, ja, to fall asleep. Schlafen allein, is only to sleep berapa jam, yeah, like a baby. Yeah, I just is just to fall asleep. So, when you have done your homework for today, you are ready to pass it up.
Yes.
Anything you want to recorrect there after the class today?
Yeah.
I ask you only.
Yes.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. Okay. Then you pass up next week. Okay. So, but make sure that you know your sentence structures, because we will use this class for talking, more on talking. Yeah. And what I did not do with you today, but with the group this morning, was this here. Maybe that is the homework, right? We went through Laura's schedule and wrote every single question and answer on the board. So when you think it is a need to do that for you as well, because I thought your question so far okay. But when it comes to the schedule, maybe you don't specify some questions here. Yeah? Maybe you can do it for one sample. You have done now sentences, isn't it? For your own schedule, isn't it? So when you make questions then, what do I do at 9 o'clock? At 10 o'clock, which activity is there on? Something like this. You need the question word one for Pila, when, yeah, and what. When do I do what? And when what do I do at which time? These two question types. Okay? When you make, for each one sample should be enough already. And then the sentences you have from your own schedule, you just go through again if they are right. Okay, so you just add on two questions. Yeah? Any questions from your side? Yeah, when do you do what and what do you do at a special time? Yeah, should be enough. I think you are quite okay with the question. Alright?